Very good afternoon, student. Today let me start the physics class. The topic name is nuclear fusion. What is mean by nuclear fusion? This is the definition of nuclear fusion. The process in which two lighter nuclei combine to form a heavier nucleus is termed as nuclear fusion. So once again repeat, the process in which two lighter nuclei combine to form a heavier nucleus is termed as nuclear fusion. So this is the definition of nuclear fusion. Very very important definition, children, please note it down. The next thing is, you have learned that the energy can be produced when a heavy nucleus is split up into two smaller nuclei. Similarly, energy can be produced when two lighter nuclei combine to form a heavier nucleus. This phenomenon is known as nuclear fusion. This is the equation to understand the nuclear fusion. When the hydrogen represent an isotope of hydrogen known as deuterium, the average energy released in each fusion reaction is about, this is very very important value, children, please note it down, 3.84 into 10 power minus 12 joule. So each fusion reaction is about 3.84 into 10 power minus 12 joule. In this figure, we can understand this nuclear fusion. Two lighter nuclei joined together form a heavier nuclei. So this is the diagram for the nuclear fusion. The mass of the daughter nucleus formed during a nuclear reaction, fission and fusion is lesser than the sum of the masses of the two parent nuclei. The mass of the daughter nucleus formed during a nuclear reaction, fission and fusion is lesser than the sum of the masses of the two parent nuclei. This difference is in mass is called mass defect. So this is the definition of mass defect. Once again repeat, the mass of the daughter nucleus formed during a nuclear fusion is lesser than the sum of the mass of the two parent nuclei. This difference is in mass is called mass defect. This mass is covered into energy. This mass is converted into energy. According to the mass energy equivalence, this concept of mass energy equivalence was proposed by Einstein in 1905. It stated that mass can be converted into energy and vice versa. The relation between mass and energy proposed by Einstein is very important equation, children, please note it down. E is equal to mc square. So this is the relation between the mass and energy proposed. Mass and energy equation. Where c is the velocity of light in vacuum and is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. So do you know the nuclear bomb that was dropped in Hiroshima during World War II was called as Little Boy? The bomb is called as a Little Boy. It was a gun type bomb which used a uranium core. The bomb which was subsequently dropped over Nagasaki was called as Fat Man. It was an explosion type bomb which used a plutonium core. Now the condition, very very important topic, condition necessary for nuclear fusion. What are the condition necessary for the nuclear fusion? Earth atmosphere contains a small trace of hydrogen. If nuclear fusion is a spontaneous process at normal temperature and pressure, then a number of fusion process would happen in the atmosphere, which may lead to explosion. So this is very important point, children. Earth atmosphere contains a small trace of hydrogen. If nuclear fusion is a spontaneous process, spontaneous means continuous, at normal temperature and pressure, then a number of fusion process would happen in the atmosphere, which may lead to explosion. But we do not encounter any such explosion. Can you explain why? The answer is that nuclear fusion can take place only under certain condition. What are the condition? Nuclear fusion is possible only at an extremely high temperature of the order of 10 power 7. This point is very important point. 10 power 7 to 10 power 9 Kelvin and the high pressure to push the hydrogen nuclei closer to fuse with each other. Hence, it is named as thermonuclear reaction. It is named as thermonuclear reaction. So, nuclear fusion is possible. This is the first point. Nuclear fusion is possible only at extremely high temperature of the order of 10 power 7 to 10 power 9 Kelvin. And a high pressure to push the hydrogen nuclei closer to fuse with each other. Hence, it is named as thermonuclear reaction. Then, do you know nuclear fusion is the combination of two lighter nuclei? The charge of both nuclei is positive. So this is very very important point, children. Please note it down. The charge of both the nuclei is positive. According to electrostatic theory, when they come closer, they end to repel each other. This repulsive force will be overcome by the kinetic energy of the nuclei at a higher temperature of the order of 10 power 7 to 10 power 9 Kelvin. So this point is very very important point. This repulsive force will be overcome by the kinetic energy of the nuclei at a higher temperature of the order of 10 power 7 to 10 power 9 Kelvin. The next topic is stellar energy. What is meant by stellar energy? The stars like our sun emit a large amount of energy in the form of a light and heat. This energy is transmitted, termed as the stellar energy. So, this is the definition of stellar energy. The stars like our sun emit a large amount of energy in the form of light and heat. This energy is termed as the stellar energy. Where does this high energy come from? All the stars contain a large amount of hydrogen. So this is very important objective type question. All the stars contain a large amount of hydrogen. The surface temperature of the stars is very high, which is sufficient to induce fusion of the hydrogen nuclei. Induced fusion, very high, which is sufficient to induce fusion of the hydrogen nuclei. Fusion reaction that takes place in the core of the sun and other stars result in an enormous amount of energy, which is called stellar energy. This point is very important point, children. please note it down. Fusion reaction that take place in the core of the sun and other stars result in an enormous amount of energy, which is called as stellar energy. Thus, nuclear fusion or thermonuclear reaction is the source of light and heat energy in the sun and other stars. The next very important topic is hydrogen bomb. Hydrogen bomb is the example of nuclear fusion. So, hydrogen bomb is based on the principle of nuclear fusion. So, this is a very important objective type points. Hydrogen bomb is based on the principle of nuclear fusion. So, a hydrogen bomb is always designed to have an inbuilt atom bomb, which creates the high temperature and pressure required for fusion when it explodes. Then fusion takes place in the hydrogen core and lead to the release of the very large amount of energy in an uncontrolled manner. The energy released in a hydrogen bomb or fusion bomb is much higher than that released in an atom bomb or fission bomb. So, very important point is, a hydrogen bomb is always designed to have an inbuilt atom bomb, which creates the, this point is very important point, creates the high temperature and pressure required for fusion when it explodes. Then fusion takes place in the hydrogen core and leads to the release of a very large amount of energy in an uncontrolled manner. This point also very important point. The energy released in a hydrogen bomb or fusion bomb is much higher than that released in an atom bomb or fission bomb. So, this is very important. 2 mark question, children. This tabulation is very, very important to understand the nuclear fusion and the nuclear fission. There are 4 points here. First point is, what is meant by nuclear fission? The process of breaking up, splitting of a heavy nucleus into 2 smaller nuclei is called nuclear fission. What is meant by nuclear fusion? Nuclear fusion is the combination of 2 lighter nuclei to form a heavier nucleus. Second point, can be performed at room temperature for the nuclear fission. Extremely high temperature and pressure is needed for nuclear fusion. Then the third point, alpha, beta and gamma radiations are emitted for the nuclear fission. For the nuclear fusion, alpha rays, positron and neutrinos are emitted. For nuclear fusion, the fourth point is, fission leads to emission of gamma radiation. This triggers the mutation in the human gene and causes genetic transform disease. For nuclear fusion, only light and heat energy is emitted. The next, sun fuses about 620 million, so please underline, 620 million metric tons of hydrogen each second and radiates about 3×10^26 joules per second. So, this is very important value. Radiated about 3.8×10^26 joule of energy per second. When this energy is radiated towards the earth, it decreases in its intensity. When it reaches the earth, its value is about, this is also very important value, 1.4 kilojoule per unit area in unit time. The next important topic, important detailed question answer topic and then objective type question also. Uses of radioactivity. many radioisotopes can be obtained from radioactivity. These radioisotopes have found wide variety of application. In the field of medicine, agriculture, industry and archaeological research. First one is, what is the uses in agriculture? The radioisotope of phosphorus P32, this is very important example. Phosphorus P32 helps to increase the productivity of crops. The radiations from the radioisotopes can be used to kill the insect and parasites and prevent the wastage of agricultural products. So certain perishable exposed to radiation remains fresh beyond their normal life, enhancing the storage time. Very small dose of radiation prevent sprouting and spoilage of onion, potatoes and grams. So this is the very important uses for the agriculture purpose, radioisotope. Medicine. Medical applications of radioisotopes can be divided into two parts. One is that diagnosis. Second one is therapy. So radioisotopes are used as tracers to diagnose the nature of circulatory disorders of blood, defects of bone metabolism, to locate tumors. So this is very important, to locate tumor, bone metabolism, then disorders of blood. So these difficulties find out by the help of radioisotopes. Some of the radioisotopes which are used to tracers are hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur, etc. Example. So this is very important point, children, underline. Hydrogen, carbon, nitrogen, sulfur, etc. So radioisotope, this point is very very important point. Please listen carefully, underline. Radio sodium Na224 is used for the effective functioning of heart. Radio iodine I-131 used to cure goiter. Radio ion Fe-59 is used to diagnose anemia and also to provide treatment for the same. The last one, radio phosphorus P32 is used in the treatment of skin disease. Then next point is radio cobalt CO60 and radio gold AU198 are used in the treatment of skin cancer. Radiation are used to sterilize the surgical devices as they can kill the germs and microbes. Then industries uses. The industries radioactive isotopes are used as tracers to detect any manufacturing defects such as cracks and leaks. Packaging faults can also be identified through radioactivity. Gauges which have radioactive sources are used in many industries to check the level of gases, liquids and solids. So these two points also very important point. An isotope of californium CF252 you used in the airline to detect the explosive in the luggage. An isotope of americium AM241 is used to many industries as a smoke detector. The next, archaeological research. Using the technique of radiocarbon dating, the age of the earth, very important things, children, please note it down. The age of the year can be find out by the archaeological research. Fossil old painting and monuments can be determined. In radiocarbon dating, the exciting amount of radiocarbon is determined, and this gives an estimate about the age of these things. The next important topic is safety measures. So this is also important topic for your objective type question. Listen carefully. Safety measures. In day-to-day life, you do receive some natural radiation from the sun. In day-to-day life, you do receive some natural radiation from the sun. The radioactive elements present in the soil and rocks, the household appliances like television, microwave oven, cell phones and the x-rays used in hospitals. These radiation do not produce any severe effect as they are very low in intensity. The second source of radiation exposure in man-made, these are due to nuclear reactors and during the testing of the nuclear devices in the atmosphere or in the ground. Improper and careless handling of radioactive materials release harmful radiation in our environment. These radiation are very harmful to the human body. A person who is exposed to radiation very closely or for a long duration is at a greater health risk and can be affected genetically. How old is our Mother Earth? Any guesses? It is nearly 4. So this value is very important value. It is nearly 4.54 × 10⁻ years. Around 45 crore 40 lakhs years. Wow. Percentage range. The International Commission on Radiological Protection, ICRP, has recommended certain maximum permissible exposure limit to radiation that is believed to be safe without producing any appreciable injury to a person. Safe limit of overall exposure to radiation is given as 20 millisievert per year. In terms of Rontgen, so Rontgen is the unit of radiation. Please underline this word. Rontgen is the unit of radiation. The safe limit of receiving the radiation is about 100 millirontgen per week. So this is very important point, children. Please note it down. This is important objective type question. The safe limit of receiving the radiation is about 100 millirontgen per week. If the exposure is 100 rontgen, it may cause fatal diseases like leukemia, death of red blood corpuscle in the blood, or cancer. When the body is exposed to about 600 rontgen, it leads to death. So this is very important point. Please underline. When the body is exposed to about 600 rontgen, it leads to death. Dosimeter is a device used to detect the levels of exposure to an ionizing radiation. It is frequently used in the environments where exposure to radiation may occur, such as nuclear power plants and medical imaging facilities. Pocket dosimeter is used to provide the wearer with an immediate reading of his or exposure to X-rays and gamma rays. The next, preventive measures. So this is also very important topic for your objective type question. Radioactive material should be kept in a thick walled lead conductor. Radioactive material should be kept in a thick walled lead container. Radioactive material should be kept in a thick walled lead container because lead only it is stop the radiation. Lead, the metal lead is used to stop the radiation from the radioisotope materials. Lead coated aprons and lead gloves should be used while working with hazardous radioactive materials. The next point, you should avoid heating while handling radioactive materials. The radioactive material should be handled only by tongs or by a remote control device. Then the last prevention is, dosimeters should be worn by the users to check the level of radiation. Once again repeat, radioactive material should be kept in a thick walled lead container. Lead coated aprons and lead gloves should be used while working with the hazardous radioactive materials. You should avoid eating while handling radioactive materials. The radioactive material should be handled only by tongs or by a remote control device. Dosimeter should be worn by the users to check the level of radiation. Next, very very important detailed question answer. Nuclear reactor. Nuclear reactor is based on the principle of nuclear fission process. So this topic is very very important topic, children. Please listen carefully. Breeder reactor. So this is nuclear reactor is a device in which the nuclear fission reaction takes place in the self-sustained and controlled manner to produce electricity. The first nuclear reactor was built in 1942 at Chicago, USA. Types of nuclear reactors. What are the types of nuclear reactors? The answer is breeder reactor, fast breeder reactor, pressurized water reactor, pressurized heavy water reactor, boiling water reactor, water cooled reactor, gas cooled reactor, fusion reactor and thermal reactor are some types of nuclear reactors which are used in different places worldwide. Then components of nuclear reactors. What are the components in nuclear reactor? Means the essential component of nuclear reactors are fuel, moderator, control rod, coolant and protection valve. Fuel. A fissile material is used as the fuel. The commonly used fuel material is uranium. The moderator. A moderator is used to slow down the high energy neutrons to provide slow neutrons. Graphite and heavy water are the commonly used moderators. Then control rod. Control rods are used to control the number of neutrons in order to have sustained chain reaction. Mostly boron boron or cadmium rods are used in control rods. They absorb the neutrons. In moderator, graphites and heavy waters are the commonly used moderator. What is the purpose of moderator? A moderator is used to slow down the higher energy neutrons to provide the slow neutrons. Control rod, what is the purpose of control rod? Control rods are used to control the number of neutrons in order to have sustained chain reaction. So these components are used in control rods. Boron or cadmium rods are used in the control rods. They absorb the neutrons. Then coolant. A coolant is used to remove the heat produced in the nuclear reactor. So what is the purpose of coolant. A coolant is used to remove the heat produced in the reactor core to produce steam. This steam is used to run a turbine or turbine in order to produce electricity. So this is very important line. The steam is produced to run a turbine here. Turbine in order to produce electricity. Water, air and helium are some of the coolant. So underline this word, this sentence. Water, air and helium are some of the coolants. The last, protection wall. A thick concrete lead wall is built around the nuclear reactor in order to prevent the harmful radiation from escaping into the environment. So thick concrete lead wall built around the nuclear reactor. So this is the picture of nuclear reactor. Then nuclear uses of a nuclear reactor. So very important topic. This is very important topic for your 2-mark question as well as objective type question. Nuclear reactors are widely used in power generation. Nuclear reactors are widely used in power generation. Second one is, they are also used to produce radioisotopes, which are used in a variety of applications. Then third one is, some reactors help us to do research in the field of nuclear physics. The last one, breeder reactors are used to convert non-fissionable materials into fissionable materials. Then, nuclear power plants in India. This topic also very important topic for your objective type question. Indian Atomic Energy Commission, AEC, was established in August 1948 by the Department of Indian Scientific Research Committee at Bombay, now Mumbai, in Maharashtra. It is the nodal agency for all the research done in the field of atomic energy. Dr. Homi Jahangir Bhabha was the first chairman of Indian Atomic Energy Commission. Now it is known as Bhabha Atomic Research Center, BARC. Nuclear power is the fifth largest source of power in India. Tarapur Atomic Power Station is India's first nuclear power station. So please underline. Now there are a total of 7 power stations, one each in Maharashtra, Rajasthan, Gujarat, Uttar Pradesh and 2 in Tamil Nadu. In Tamil Nadu, we have nuclear power station in Kalpakkam and Kudangulam. Apsara was the first nuclear reactor built in India and Asia. Now, there are 22 nuclear reactors which are operating in India. So, this is very important point. 22 nuclear reactors which are operating in India. Some other operating reactors are Sirius, Dhruva, Purnima. So, some solved problem given your textbook based on the nuclear reaction. Identify A, B, C and D from the following nuclear reaction. This equation is based on the nuclear reaction. Solution. 13 Al power 27 into A, it is nothing but helium. 2 He power 4. Which gives the 15 phosphorus 30, B is neutron. By this reaction, 12 magnesium 24 plus neutron 0 N1, which gives 11 sodium 24 plus hydrogen 1 H1. The third, 92 uranium 238 plus the B is nothing but neutron 0 N1, which gives 93 napoleon 239 plus electron minus 1 e power 0. A is the alpha particle. So the answer is A is the alpha particle, B is neutron, C is proton and D is electron. Then solved problems. 6.2 in your textbook. A radon specimen emits radiation of 3.7 into 10 power 3 gigabecquerel per second. Convert this disintegration in terms of curie. 1 curie is equal to 3.7 into 10 power 10 disintegration per second. So how will you convert? 1 becquerel is equal to 1 disintegration per second. 1 curie is equal to 3.7 into 10 power 10 becquerel. So 1 becquerel is equal to 1 divided by 3.7 into 10 power 10 curie. So 3.7 into 10 power 3 gigabecquerel means, giga means 10 power 9. So 3.7 into 10 power 3 into 10 power 9 into 1 by 3.7 into 10 power 10. The answer is 3.7, 3.7 cancelled each other. This 10 power 10 goes to numerator side, 10 power minus 10. So 10 power minus 10 plus 10 power 12 is nothing but 10 power 2. 10 power 2 means 100. 100 curie. Answer is 100 curie. The next problem is 92 uranium 235. Experience 1 alpha decay and 1 beta decay. Find the number of neutrons in the final daughter nucleus that is formed. Let X and Y be the resulting nucleus after the emission of the alpha and beta particles respectively. So 92 uranium 235 in alpha decay process, 90X 231 plus 2 He power 4, that means helium. The next equation, 90X power 231, which gives beta decay process, 91Y 231 plus minus 1, so that means electron minus 1 e power 0. So number of neutrons, mass number minus atomic number. Mass number is 231, atomic number is 91. Mass number is 231, atomic number is 91. So mass number 231 minus 91 is equal to 140. That is the number of neutrons. The next problem is, calculate the amount of energy released when a radioactive substance undergoes fusion and results in a mass defect of 2 kilograms. So mass defect in the reaction, m is equal to 2 kilograms. Velocity of light c is equal to 3 into 10 power 8 meter per second. By Einstein equation, energy released, that means E is equal to mc square. So E is equal to m value is 2 into c square value is 3 into 10 power 8 the whole power square. So multiply these two terms, we get, that means energy released is equal to 1.8 into 10 power 17 joule. 1.8 into 10 power 17 joule. The next one is point to remember. It is very, very important. What is meant by natural radioactivity? This is the definition of natural radioactivity. This phenomenon of spontaneous emission of radiation for certain elements on its own is called natural radioactivity. Second one is curie definition. Curie is defined as the quantity of radioactivity substance which undergoes 3.7 into 10 power 10 disintegration in 1 second. This is actually close to the activity of 1 gram of radiation, radium-226. Then Rutherford, definition of Rutherford is, Rutherford is defined as the quantity of a radioactivity substance which produces 10 power 6 disintegration in 1 second. Rutherford is equal to 10 power 6 radiation per second. Then becquerel definition is, the SI unit of radioactivity is becquerel. It is defined as the quantity of 1 disintegration per second. Then this is the point of helium nucleus consisting of 2 proton and 2 neutron is known as alpha particles. Beta particles are electrons, which are basic elementary particles present in all atoms. Then gamma rays are electromagnetic waves consisting of photons. The next important point, a nuclear reaction in which an unstable parent nuclei which emits an alpha particles and forms a stable daughter nucleus is called as alpha decay. Then a nuclear reaction in which an unstable parent nucleus emits a beta particle and forms a stable daughter nucleus is called beta decay. The process of breaking or splitting up of a heavier nucleus into two smaller nucleus with the release of the large amount of energy is called nuclear fission. This is the definition of nuclear fission. The next, the energy released in a nuclear fission process is about 200 mega electron volt. This is also a very important point. The energy released in a nuclear fission process is about 200 mega electron volt. There are some radioactive element which can be converted into fissionable material. They are called as fissile materials. Example, uranium-238, thorium-232, plutonium-240. Controlled chain reaction is used in a nuclear reactor to produce in a sustained and controlled manner. The process in which two lighter nuclei combine to form a heavier nucleus is termed as nuclear fusion. Nuclear fusion or thermonuclear reaction is the source of light and heat energy in the sun and other stars. The safe limit of receiving the radiation is about 100 milli Roentgen per week. This is very, very important point. So that's all. This class complete your physics portion also. So I will give a notes for writing the class work. In this class, student, you must complete your class notework in your physics class notework. So physics, this notes, write your physics class notework. Thank you.